OnSong is a powerful app for musicians that keeps you organized so you can focus on the music. Replace your binder with just one app that features tools to improve your performance on stage or in the practice room. OnSong is an app that runs on iOS devices like iPad, iPhone, or iPod Touch. To install, go into the App Store and search for OnSong, and then tap Buy. OnSong is a universal app purchased on your Apple ID so you can install it on any iOS device you own. Once installed, tap on the OnSong icon to start it up. When you first open OnSong, you'll be greeted with a registration page. Enter your name and email address so we can keep in touch. The next screen gives you access to tutorials like this one, the user manual, and other settings. If you don't want this screen to pop up when OnSong is loaded, turn it off using the switch here at the bottom. Now, if you want to watch videos outside of the app, go to onsongapp.com/videos. Or you can read the user manual in your web browser by going to onsongapp.com/docs. Let's get acquainted. OnSong lets you focus on your music, so it's no surprise that most of the screen is the song viewer. At the top, we have the menu bar. This is where you access your songs, control how you share your music, and how it appears on the screen. On the bottom right is the live bar, which gives you big buttons for toggling auto scroll, backing tracks, and a metronome. Let's start by creating our own song. This will show you how easy it is to create new songs using a simple text editor. Tap on the Songs menu and make sure that the All Songs tab is selected. This will show you a list of songs. If a list of songs doesn't appear, tap on the button in the upper left corner until you get to the library screen. Then choose the default library and then All Songs to show all the songs in your library. Make sense? Now let's tap on the plus icon in the lower right to open the Add Song screen. You can see there are many ways to import files or music you already have access to. We're going to be writing a song from scratch, so let's tap on Add New Song at the top of the list to open the song editor. OnSong loads a sample song to show you some of the basics of the OnSong file format. Really, this is just a simple text file with some formatting conventions. Tap somewhere within the text, and then tap again to choose the Select All menu option. And then choose Cut. Now we have a blank slate to start writing our song. The first line of our file is the title of the song, so let's type the song title here, and hit Return. The second line can optionally be the artist. Let's type in an artist. After that, you can specify other information about the song using metadata tags. For instance, here we type in key, followed by a colon, and type a letter A through G. We can also type an optional M to indicate minor keys. Let's also add a tempo with the tempo tag, and a time signature with the time tag. Now let's tap the return key twice to make a blank line. Blank lines in OnSong create sections. Sections are used for parts of the song, like verse or chorus. Note that the very first section of our song is always going to be called the metadata section. This contains information about the song, like the title. Now that we've created a new section, let's type in some lyrics for the first verse, like this. But how will you, your band, or OnSong know it's the first verse? Well, we can label it. At the beginning of the first line of the verse, type verse 1, followed by a colon, and then hit return. When you type a name followed by a colon and an immediate line break, everything following this will be recognized as verse 1 until another section label is encountered. Now, if you have lyrics that ends with a colon, you can still do that by typing a space after the colon so it's not recognized as a section label. We can continue to type in the song and new sections. Let's put in a chorus here and label it. Now let's tap Done to save our changes and view our song. Now this song would work great for vocalists, but it doesn't contain any chords. If you play an instrument, that could be a problem. Now let's take a look at two different ways that we can add chords to our lyrics. One of the most common ways to designate chords is by typing the chords on a line above the lyrics and using spaces to align those chords. Let's tap on the pencil icon in the upper right corner to edit our song. Start by making a new line and then tap on the spacebar until we position the cursor above the lyrics where the chord change occurs. Type the name of the chord. OnSong understands alphabetic chords with sharps and flats using the pound or lowercase b. It also supports common chord variations like M for minor, sus4 for suspended chords, number designations like 2, 5, 6, 7, 9, 11, 13, and even slash chords to denote chords played over a bass note like this. Once we have some chords in our editor, we can use the quick chord bar above the keyboard to insert chords that we've already used, as well as some other handy characters. Keep adding chords above your lyrics until you're done. Then tap Done. Let's view our chord chart. Now that the chords are detected, we can do some neat things. Tap on the sliders icon in the upper right corner to open the Style Preferences menu. Here we can adjust the size of our title and metadata. You can also adjust the overall lyric size and chord sizes. Because OnSong is detecting our chords, we can also bold or highlight those chords. We can even move the transpose slider to transpose our song to a different key. Pretty neat, huh? But here's the deal. OnSong needs to determine whether each line in your song contains chords or not. To do that, it actually detects what a chord is and what it isn't. That means that if you have a line of chords that contains something that's not a chord, that line of chords may not be detected. Let's open our song editor and see what I mean. We type in some other words on a chord line and tap Done. Now you'll see that the line of chords is not positioned, formatted, or transposed. OnSong has the ability to ignore certain things in that line. Let's open the song editor and then wrap anything that's not a chord in parentheses to use both chords and instructions on one line. Now when we tap Done, we can see the chords are positioned, formatted, and transposed, and our note is intact. One issue with chords over lyrics is that it requires a lot of spaces, and if we change our lyrics, we have to also go through and change our chord positions. Let's open the song editor again and see what I mean. Let's say we want to combine the first and second line of the verse to make one longer line. This can be useful to make more of the song visible at a glance. When we are using chords over lyrics, this gets really difficult and we need to do a lot of copy, paste, and chord shifting to make it happen. Instead, let's go to our Text Tools menu by tapping on the hammer icon. Let's switch from chords over lyrics to bracketed chords. Take a look at what this did. You'll see now our chords are placed on the same line as the lyrics, but the chords are surrounded by square brackets. Now we can just go to the front of the second line and tap Delete to bring it up to the same line. All of our chords move along with the lyrics, which is really handy. Sometimes you want to provide musical direction or instructions in your chord chart. OnSong provides a really simple way to do that. Let's say we want to repeat the chorus. Go into the song editor and type Repeat after the chorus on a separate line. When the text is surrounded by parentheses, it's considered a musical instruction and formatted differently. It also won't appear when you're projecting lyrics. Using text files is really the best way to use OnSong, but let's say you already have some files that you want to import into OnSong instead. OnSong supports a number of file formats, such as PDF, that are commonly used for chord charts. To see which file formats OnSong supports, go to onsongapp.com/docs/features/formats. Let's see how easy it is to import from Dropbox. Dropbox is a cloud-based storage service that lets you easily transfer files to your OnSong library without any wires. You can sign up for a free account at dropbox.com or by using the Dropbox app. During the sign-up process, you enter your email and password. If you're not using the Dropbox app, you'll need that to sign into Dropbox using OnSong. Now let's tap on the Songs menu again and make sure we're viewing all songs. Tap on the plus button and choose Import from Dropbox. If you've installed the Dropbox app on your iPad or iPhone, you'll be redirected to the Dropbox app to authorize OnSong to access your Dropbox. If you don't have the Dropbox app installed, Dropbox will present a sign-in screen inside of the OnSong app to authorize access. Sign in and your full Dropbox will be displayed. Please note that your username and password for Dropbox are never shared with OnSong. This is all going through the Dropbox interface that OnSong uses. Now let's locate some files you want to import and tap on each to place a checkmark next to them. Then tap on the import button in the upper right corner. Great, our songs are imported. We're really starting to build our library of music. Quick access to your songs is really important. OnSong automatically organizes your music in a number of different ways to make sure that it's quickly available to you. The Songs menu lets you browse and search your songs. search by tapping in the search bar. OnSong searches your title and even the song content. You can also sort your songs. To do that, tap on the sort button in the lower left corner and choose how you would like to sort them. You can also view your songs by artist and key. All of this organization happens automatically from the information you've provided in the song editor. When you find a song you like, tap on it to view. Now that's great for practice, but what if you're playing a gig and need to quickly flip through your songs? For that, you'll want to create a set. To create a set, tap on the Songs menu and then choose My Sets in the tab bar on the right to view all sets. To create a set, tap on the plus button on the bottom right. Sets automatically assign the day that you've created them. You can change the date or optionally provide a title that better expresses the set list. There's some other options here as well. For instance, folders let you group your sets together. This is useful if you want to organize your sets by venue or band. Separate song set styles lets songs in this set have a different key, style, tempo, or backing track that's independent from the original song or other sets. Audio playback continuity can be used to play continuously through linked backing tracks without stopping. Let's just tap Done to create our set. Now we want to add some songs to it. To do this, we tap on the set to view it and then tap on the plus button in the lower right corner. Here we have all the songs in our library. Tap on the songs we want to place in the set. The initial order of the songs in the set will be the order that you select them. Now tap Done and we've built our set. But this might not be the order that you want to play the songs in. How do we change that? Simple. Tap on the Edit button in the upper right and then use the reordering handles on the right side of each row to move the songs where you like. Once we have it just right, tap Done to save your changes. To remove a song from the list, swipe right to left and then tap Remove. You can add other songs or add the songs back by tapping on the plus button and choosing them again. Now let's tap on the first song in the set. This takes us to the beginning of our set list. Tap off the menu to view the song. If we want to view the song full screen, tap in the middle of the screen to hide the menu bar. If we tap in the middle again, it will show the menu bar. You can swipe up or down to scroll, or tap on the top and bottom of the screen to scroll your song. You can also swipe right or tap on the right side of the screen to move to the next song in our set. Then swipe left or tap on the left to move to the previous song in the set. Now, while swiping and tapping is good for practice, it's a little difficult to do during performance. OnSong works with foot pedals to let you control OnSong without touching the screen. Tap on the foot pedals icon in the menu bar to configure a foot pedal with OnSong. You can swipe left and right until you find the right foot pedal for you. Here we've selected the new AirTurn Ped. You can then tap on each foot pedal on the screen to set actions. OnSong is configured by default to scroll the song up and down and navigate through your set with just two pedals. But you can also choose from dozens of other actions depending on how many foot pedals you have. In this video, we've seen how you can create songs in a way that lets you quickly format and transpose them. We've also added songs to your OnSong library through Dropbox and pulled a set list. Be sure to watch our other video tutorials to see how you can do even more with OnSong. Thanks for watching, and remember, if you ever have any questions, be sure to contact us at support@onsongapp.com.